One other item on the agenda, we have an agenda that is for the mayor's issues. That situation where talks of responsibility, I thought we had to deal with our street commissioner, which he has the knowledge to do inspection on roads. I had discussed it with the TIF board. They agreed to pay for his time when they were busy doing blacktopping. It was paid for. And it's not city, reimbursed by the TIF. The state board council says we can't legally do that. Because he's a salaried person, even though it's 2 o'clock in the morning. They said we can't do that now, so he has to pay that back, or someone has to pay it back. And the Bill and Helen and I, which one personnel committee, sit down and discussed it.
Ken's here, and Ken can speak to as well. As part of the construction project, there was a need for inspectors, and it seemed to be beneficial to the city and even a cost savings, if I remember correctly, to hire Mark Klosterkemper as an inspector. That was done, but what the State Board of Council said is that the duties that he performed as part of that project were very similar to the duties that he performs as within his department position. And because he is an exempt employee, the State Board of Council says you can't, it's almost treated as overtime as opposed to a separate project as a private inspector. So what they're saying is, needs to pay that money back. And a solution to the issue, and this happens, as I understand with State Board of Accounts, with other communities, this happens with some regularities. If someone is overpaid or underpaid, what you do is you have to address the issue moving forward. You can't pay them money for services to be rendered in retrospectives. And so you can make a salary adjustment. A one-time salary adjustment for the exact same monies, if that's what you're going to do. But it has to be going forward. You can't, and it would be prorated over the period of a year. I mean, it's not something that you can't have to pay it back for all 11 and hand it to them for all 12. If that makes any sense. I mean, I don't know if I'm making any sense.
we talk about logs?
It's under
484.34. So about 5,000.
500. Yes.
The problem that we have here was it was in direct violation of our personnel policy, and he's an exempt employee, and you can't pay him. According to the state board of accounts, you couldn't pay an exempt employee any more than what their exempt wages are. So we didn't feel the need to change our personnel policy for one time, which could cause ripple effect for other exempt employees. So we wanted to keep it where it was at, and we wanted to reverse the negative that was done to get it back. Nobody doubts that Martin can do that job well. Probably deserves that money, and I think I said that to me. Mm-hmm. He probably deserves it more than anything. But the whole point of it was that decision was made. We weren't aware of it until the previous personnel policy meeting. And by then, was he already paid some money?
He, one time, was he paid? We could, the TIF could save more money, but because of what happened the first time, we stopped it.
So the only thing we could think of as a personnel committee was to reverse that.
Now, my only concern is, how do you rectify someone who got up out of bed at 1 o'clock to go to work to do a service for the industry project? How do you compensate them for that? Say, sorry, you're out of luck. I understand it has to be repaid by law. That has to be done.
And I think the thing that concerns me is, you know, we have to stay all the and he says, you can't do this. And I know, Mayor, when it was presented to the TIF board, I was one of the ones who voted unanimously for it because it did make sense. Not really thinking of the repercussions, you know, of the auditor coming in. I guess the thing that concerns me is if we try to find a way to justify it, would it look like we're creating loophole to...
But you understand. But State Board of Accounts, that's not a problem. Right, Tim?
Well, I mean...
Maybe that's what the auditor pulled as long as you got this paid.
The council's well within itself to do a salary adjustment and say it's one time and have it equal the same amount. But, I mean, it's, it has the ability to do that. The issue, I think, Darryl, that I want to make clear on it, the issue is the State Board of Accounts is looking at this and saying, we think this is an over, very similar job duties. And but if it was dissimilar, then the State Board of Accounts would say, well, no, it's two, the job is not treated as overtime. So what you've got is you've got this gray area, if you will, or the State Board of Accounts has the ability as the auditor to come in and say, well, this is our opinion, it's too similar, so this is the ruling, if you